here in the House. What makes you think you can get on board with some of the things that Donald Trump is talking about when it comes to policy?
Let me say this. I think we had a very encouraging meeting. Look, it's no secret that Donald Trump and I have had our differences. We talked about those differences today. That's common knowledge. The question is, what is that we need to do to unify the Republican Party and all strains of conservative wings in the party? We had a very good and encouraging, productive conversation on just how to do that. It was important that we discussed our differences that we have, but it was also important that we discussed the core principles that tie us all together. Principles like the Constitution, the separation of powers, the fact that we have an executive that is going way beyond the boundaries of the Constitution, and how it's important to us that we restore Article 1 of the Constitution. You know, it's the principle of self-government. We talked about life and how strongly we feel about this core principle. We talked about the Supreme Court and things like this. I was very encouraged with what I heard from Donald Trump today. I do believe that we are now planting the seeds to get ourselves unified, to bridge the gaps and differences. And so from here, we're going to go deeper into the policy areas to see where that common ground is and how we can make sure that we are operating off these same core principles. And so, yes, this is our first meeting. I was very encouraged with this meeting. But this is a process. It takes a little time. You don't put it together in 45 minutes. So that is why we had, like I said, a very good start to a process on how we unify.
But you don't think that it's an issue of
Jonathan. Look,
if you're not, what is holding you back? And do you really have a choice? I mean,
the process of unifying the Republican Party, which just finished a primary about a week ago, perhaps one of the most divisive primaries in memory, takes some time. Look, there are people who are for Donald Trump, who are for Ted Cruz, or for John Kasich, who are for Marco Rubio and everybody else. And it's very important that we don't fake unifying, we don't pretend unification, that we truly and actually unify so that we are full strength in the fall. I don't want us to have a fake unification process here. I want to make sure that we really truly understand each other and that we are committed to the conservative principles that make the Republican Party, that built this country. And again, I'm very encouraged. I heard a lot of good things from our presumptive nominee, and we exchanged differences of opinion on a number of things that, you know, everybody knows we have. There are policy disputes that we will have. There's no two ways about it. Plenty of Republicans disagree with one another on policy disputes, but on core principles. Those are the kinds of things that we discussed. And again, I'm encouraged. Craig. Yeah, I think this is going in a positive direction, and I think this is a first very encouraging meeting. But again, in 45 minutes, you don't litigate all of the processes and all the issues and the principles that we are talking about. I didn't catch that.
Yeah, can you offer any assurances that he would change or moderate?
Look, I think it's important that the kind of conversation we had is between the two of us, and no offense, but I don't want to litigate our conversation through the media, because I think when you're beginning to get to know someone, you have a good conversation of trust between each other. So I want to keep the things we discussed between the two of us, because they were very important and they were personal in some senses. And that means we talked about what it takes to unify, where our differences were, and how we can bridge these gaps going forward so that we're strong as a party going into the fall. Let me give Wong. He did. I am the Speaker of the House. I am happy to serve in this capacity at the chair of our convention if our presumptive nominee wants me to do so. I see that as it's the delegates who technically make that decision, but I would honor the decision of our presumptive nominee, and he did express that interest. Let me go, Halperin. Yeah, so. His personality, I thought he's a very good personality. He's a very warm and genuine person. Like I said, I met him for like 30 seconds in 2012. So we really don't know each other. And we started to get to know each other. So I actually had a very pleasant exchange with him. That's point number one. Point number two, look, there are just things we really believe in as conservatives. We believe in limited government. We believe in the Constitution. We believe in the proper role of the differences in the separation of powers. We believe in things like life. I know we're not everyone is pro-choice in our party, and we accept all comers, but we are a majority pro-life party, and these are things that are important to us. And so we just had a good exchange of views on these kinds of issues. I think he's over having the same conversation with the Senate right now. Our leaders met with them, and everybody expressed opinions and exchanged ideas. And so the point of this is, I think we're off to an encouraging start. It is important that we get ourselves to full strength so that we can win in the fall, because the stakes could not be higher. But that it takes more than 45 minutes, Mark. We discuss those issues at great detail.
Differences in not only how conservatism is defined broadly, but how you have tried to define it for this House conference.
Right. So I represent a wing of the Conservative Party, you could say. He's bringing a whole new wing to it. He's bringing new voters that we've never had for decades. That's a positive thing. The point, though, is, can we agree on the common core principles that unite all of us? We will have policy disputes. There's no two ways about that. All Republicans did. Look, Mitt Romney and I didn't agree on everything in 2012. So we will have policy disputes. I'm not interested in litigating the past. I am interested in going forward and seeing where that common ground exists to make sure that we can have a unified Republican Party. That, yes, there will be different Republicans that have different views on various policy ideas. The question is, can we unify on common core principles that make our party, and by the way, the principles that built this country, and I'm very encouraged that the answer to that question is yes. How about one more over here? Sorry, the lady first. Yes.
You just mentioned the millions of new voters, and he's bringing in new people. I was wondering how you actually interpret his success. Is it going to mean fundamental realignment of the party because of these new voters that he's bringing in? Just how do you interpret his success?
It's really kind of unparalleled, I think. He has gotten more votes than any Republican primary nominee in Mark Wright in the history of our country. And this isn't even over yet. He hasn't even gone to like California yet. So it's really a remarkable achievement. So the question is, and this is what we think we can be a party to helping, how do we unify it all? So this is really a big and growing movement. How do we keep adding and adding and adding voters while not subtracting any voters? And to me, that means a positive vision based on core principles, taking those principles, applying them to the problems facing our country today, and offering people positive solutions, and speaking to people where they are in life, addressing their anxieties, and show that we have a better plan. Look, here's what we agree on. A Hillary Clinton presidency would be a disaster for this country. It's effectively a third Obama term. And the other thing we all know is most Americans do not like where this country is headed. 7 out of 10 Americans think America is on the wrong track. We agree with that. So the question is, can we unify around our common principles to offer the country a compelling and clear choice in an agenda going forward so that the men and women of this nation get a real and honest choice about how to fix this country and get us on a better track? And I am very encouraged that we can put that together. I'll go one more in the back. Yes, you got here late.
After your statement last week on CNN, Donald Trump said he was not ready to support your agenda. Did he change his mind today? I think you talked about Confident America agenda, and did he say he supported our agenda?
We talked about all of these issues, and our policy teams are meeting to just walk through details. So, again, this is a process. We just began the process. I'm very encouraged at the first meeting of this process. And going forward, we're going to go a little deeper into the policy weeds to make sure that we have a better understanding of one another. All right. Thank you very much, everybody. Appreciate it. Thank you.